Hey guys, welcome to Cooking with Priya in Priya's Kitchen. I missed you guys for a few days. Anyway, happy Wednesday. Hope everyone's been well. We wrapped up school yesterday, so we are done with that. Hopefully I'll be in the kitchen more often. Anyway, so that son had graduation earlier, so that was fun. And just making dinner now, so the girls are hanging out and I'm just going to get started on dinner. And before I do, hope everyone's doing well. Congrats to all the graduates. So that was really nice today, and to all the kids going forward with the new way of graduating. But it was good. We were able to social distance today, so that was pretty good. Feel a little tired. Hey son, how are you? Hey Dolly. Hey Shaliza. Hey Yvonne. Anyway, I want to tell you guys about this beautiful arrangement that was sent to me. So look at this. How pretty is this? Like, look. And I want to tell you who sent it to me. Floral Explosion sent it to me. Anton is the owner, and they're on 120th Street in Richmond Hill, and like for all occasions. I have known him for years, probably since I was 11. He used to work at Regis, so I've known him for many, many years. He's got a great floral business coming up, going on, and his flowers are super, super fresh. He also did my wedding, so that was pretty, you know, he does a really good job. So I just wanted to mention that. I'm gonna put his information on Priya's Kitchen. So if you guys want great flowers delivered even to your husbands this weekend, who knows? Definitely, you know, give him a call. He's really fast in service. He's got delivery going on. And I just wanted to mention, so it's Floral Explosion and it's in Richmond Hill, Queens on 120th Street. Hey, Yav. So I just wanted to display it because now I believe every week I'll be having nice flowers in my house to show you guys. So here it is. Ta-da! He did an amazing job with this, by the way. And so just wanted to get that out of the way. And I wanted to tell you guys what I'm making today. I'm actually making Sada Roti. And the weather's kind of like dreary and damp in Long Island right now, so in New York. And I steamed goat earlier when I came home from school. And I actually had to go in today for graduation, right? Oh, thank you so much. They're very pretty. So I'm doing squash with goat, like stew, and Sada Roti. Kind of like perfect food for today. So I'm going to actually like take my flowers. And he gives you like the prettiest vase and everything. Like, look at this. And I'm going to, hey Helena, I'm going to put in my dining room. So just give me 1 second. All right, so that's like stuck in my dining room, and I've got my pan heated here, and I'm using a heavy bottom pot right here. So I've got that going on, and I'm gonna add everything to my pot and show you guys right now. So it's got oil inside already. Like I said, let me show you what I got going on. I've got squash, I chipped it up earlier, so that's that. And I steamed out my goat. So I've got that as well. So I'm going to make like a stew with that, and we'll have it with roti. So kind of easy. I am a little tired, but gotta cook, right? So that's actually heated already. So I'm gonna just add and what I did with my goat, I washed it I'll tell you what I washed it with, a little bit of lemon juice, a little bit of salt and cold water, and some flour, just to get that gainy. Hi Fiona, how are you? Just to get that gainy kind of, taste or smell away from it. So, because it is kind of like a gainy meat, right? And then I steamed it outside with just like table season, like garlic salt, black pepper, grind garlic and pepper, paprika, and a little bit of adobo. And that's it. I just steamed it until it was like soft. So when I recook it with the vegetable, it won't have to cook like forever. So here's some onions going in my pot right now. Here we go. Hope everyone's doing well. So I'm gonna let this like cook. Just let this cook up like on this side. Hopefully you can see like the pot. The pot's kind of deep, right? So if I have to like move it around to show you guys, I will. So let my onions fry up. And what I'll do next is I'll add some tomato paste to this, right? because any good kind of stew, it's, you still want a little bit of tomato paste. So just let the tomato paste cook up with the onion. You don't want it to burn, so you definitely want to like watch it. I should have used like a wooden spoon for this. Hold on. Yeah, a wooden spoon, definitely. Hey, Antifari, how are you? So, up early this morning, 6:30, out the house at 8:30. I was there 2 days this week. I was there on Monday and I was there today for graduation, so it was nice, fun. So there we go. Let that cook up a little, just a little bit. And basically what I'm going to do, I'm great, I'm doing good. So basically what I'm going to do is just check my heat a little, right? So this is my goat meat. Yeah, very. This is my goat meat. I steamed it out already and it's just gonna be stewing up with squash. So this is going in here. And this is like cooked, like it's really like steamed well, right? Like I really steamed it out good. So when I re-cook it with the vegetable, it'll lose its own water and then it'll just like steam the vegetable and it'll just cook down really fast. And I don't know if you've had like squash with, I'm not a big fan of squash. I'm just trying to like get like everything going right now. Oh, hey Ann, how are you? Goat, I'm making stew goat with squash and Sada Roti. So, kind of like damn dreary weather in New York. So, kind of like a good comfort food day. So I'm just letting this cook up a little bit. And I did add tomato paste. So this is what this is looking like. Hopefully you can see this. Hold on. There we go. Okay, so that's what's going on with that. So I did steam it for a while, right? Because it takes like goat has like, it'll take a while to steam out. So, you know, once I've got that process out of the way, then that's like kind of easy. So just turning it up and I'm just gonna season it up a little bit. Just with a couple of things, I'm just gonna re-season it. Actually, I'm gonna put my squash in and then re-season it. So here's my squash just going in. Just gonna do half and turn it and then do the other half and turn it up. And I like lots of black pepper in this. So I like to like see the black pepper, kind of like when I'm cooking cabbage as well. I learned this from my Aunt Vashti when she cooks. She puts a lot of black pepper and that's how come I like seeing it in my squash and in my cabbage. So add in the rest of my squash to this. Hey Jackie, how are you? And this is like a Dutch pot, right? Like a cast iron Dutch pot. I mean, you could use a car heat, you could use a frying pan, you could use whatever. I just like these pots because they lock in a lot of heat and it steams really well. And I don't know if you've ever had like, you know, squash and shrimp is good. Squash and chicken is good. Squash and goat is like really good. I guess it would be like similar to like squash and beef, even though I haven't had beef, but you know, I'm sure it'll be like kind of that kind of oh, good to see you too. School's done. So I'm adding some garlic salt and I'm gonna add some paprika to it now. Gives it like a nice flavor and some fresh ground black pepper. This is what I love. I should add some ruru pepper to it, but maybe I'll just add another pepper to just give it like the steaming flavor. Hold on, watch me go dig for pepper now, right? Like I should have taken it out. Of course I did not. So let me go dig for pepper in my freezer. Sorry, guys. Voila! Hold on, let me wash it up. Hey, Shanta, how are you? Just add in this to it. Whoa! going to turn this back up right now. This looks really good. I'll show you guys in a minute. I definitely want to add some tomatoes to it, right? It'll cook it down. And I'm definitely adding some salt to it as well. I mean, I'll taste it later, but just add some salt now. Because I'm going to cover the lid, put it on low heat, and let the squash steam itself. Because most of... Hey, Andrea. Hey, girl. What's going on? I'm making squash and goat. Stew squash with goat and Sada Roti. Hopefully my Sada Roti comes out good while you guys are on. Avery likes Sada Roti, so that's why I tend to go that route instead of... I usually put it on here. I'll put it on here to rise up. She doesn't like the brown on it, so I've got a pan out to do like a separate one for her. Don't ask. Avery's my picky monster, so I'm going to switch this out. I'm actually going to just switch it to like a different burner in the back. Actually, let me show you guys what it looks like first. Hey, Shmani. This is what it's looking like. Pretty yummy. Oh, I look in my freezer, I look in my fridge, and I see what's going on, and I'm like, oh, maybe I should take that out. I had to go into school today, so they had graduation, so... I was like, I came back, I was like, oh man, what should I make? Hey Mala, how are you? And I had squash, so I was like, oh, squash and goat, it is. So, that's how I decide. Or, you know, Chalisa decides for me, right? And I do have the heat on a little bit low, right? So I don't want the heat to... I'm gonna wash my hands up while I talk to you guys, put all my stuff away. Hold on, I'm just gonna stick it here in the meantime. Wash up. Put this away. What'd you cook today, Andrea? I know. And believe it or not, it is. It's a pain. And a lot of people have been messaging me about how do you come up with this, or they've been getting ideas from when they see me cook, like to come up with different things, because it is a lot to come up with different things all the time. Like, no joke. I'm not even joking. Like, it's a lot of work. So, anyway, I'm gonna get the Sada Roti going and show you guys what's going on with that. It might be a little, like, a lot back and forth, but at least you'll be able to see what's going on with my Sada Roti. And, oh, love that too. That'll probably be like a tomorrow day. Let me see who's playing. I've got Alexa, so let me show you guys my roti. That's what's going on with that, right? I kneaded it earlier in my you know, food processor. So I did do that earlier. I feel like I want Anton's flowers to be like displayed. I gotta make sure they're displayed. I can't do that to him. He was so sweet to be sending me all these nice things. So hold on. I gotta make sure it's like displayed while I'm cooking. It was like, he's so awesome. And then you'll have something pretty to look at in my kitchen too. See? Ta-da! So, there we go. Anyway, so I'm gonna get going with the roti. Make sure you guys can see this. Hold on. There we go. So Sada Roti is really easy, right? I'll put the stove on, and what I'll do is I'll just let it rise there. You could let it rise in the microwave as well. I like when it has like the grill marks on it, and you know, it just looks nice. So here we go. Hopefully it rises. And I won't turn my stove on until I get, you know, closer. It's really soft, right? Really soft. And this is very easy. So just, you know, flour in this. A little bit of stew goat and squash with Sada Roti, can't go wrong with that. These look relatively big, but you know, you just want to get the ends going, right? Definitely want to get the ends going. And it doesn't have to be round, you know? Mine came out like, you know, like this, like it's okay. Like, it's not even a big deal. I'm actually gonna turn it like this so you guys can see. Definitely want to like put it in the pan first, and then for it to like really rise, you gotta like do it after. So I'll let the pan heat up in the meantime. Actually, I'll let the pan heat up in the meantime while I do another one, because once you do this and it just cooks, the flour cooks, the dough cooks, then you can put it to like let it rise up. So instead of it rising up in the microwave, you could just let it rise up on the stove instead. So I gotta tell you, today was pretty awesome. It was nice to see the kids graduate, and you know, they were excited, and we gave them gifts and they had little treats and stuff. I'm officially done with school, well, for now. I start summer school teaching on the July 6th. So I have a couple of weeks, so you guys will be seeing me on a lot. So I'm sorry if my voice is like a little hoarsey or raspy right now. It's just tired, a little tiring, but it's okay. I just wanted some mellow, like some mellow music. I gotta check my squash. It should be steaming though. Once that's locked up, it should definitely be steaming nicely. I got an itch. Sorry. I don't know if you ever cook roti or clean shrimp, you get an itch on your face. It's like, it's inevitable, right? So, got my other roti going. Okay, so let's see what's going on here. Let me check on the squash. Oh my god, that looks, look at that. Actually, I'm gonna turn it. I'm just gonna turn it. I mean, you could add some water if it needs a little bit of water, but I don't like, I just like keeping it on low heat, right? I don't like adding any water to it. Let me just put some water on just in case I'll need it. And you definitely wanna do, you wanna do kettle water. You don't wanna do regular water. You want it to be hot water. My pan is hot now, so here we go. Let's see, there we go. So there we go. It's my first roti going on right now. Let me get my flipper. So, oh, you like squash? Yeah. I'm not really a squash person. Avery gets all her pickiness from her mommy. Let me tell you right now. I'm like, I didn't realize it, but I am very picky with food. Like, I won't eat everybody's food. I'm a little prejudiced, I'm sorry. Or I wouldn't eat this or eat, like, I don't know. It's just weird, but that's where Amy gets it from. But if I have it with goat, like, it'll have, like, a different flavor, so I'll eat it. I guess squash and shrimp is good, too. I go on about this, right? So no pasta, no egg curry, no potato, not potato, edo, cassava, gilbaca, and catfish and stuff. I don't eat any of that stuff, so you won't see me cooking it, I'm sorry. But my friend Mona at the One Guyana Food Festival, she cooks all that stuff I don't cook, so. And, you know, we've got other people on there. By the way, thank you guys for supporting that page, right? Priya's Kitchen, and also the One Guyana Food Festival 2020. Thank you so much. And thanks to our dear friends that are on there, Mona, Terry, Vaco, everyone else that's on there, Marisha, and of course, Mr. Snow. Mr. Snow himself, Mr. Anthony Snow, who puts it all together, right? So, very, very grateful for that. So this is like swelling up nicely, even in here. So, like, look at how nice this is. And literally, I want to put it on the fire for you guys to see what's happening. Hold on. Hey, Dolly. Dolly, look at this for a minute. Let's see what's happening with the roti. I hope it swells up. Oh yeah, well you gotta try it now, doll. It's gonna be good. So let's see. It's cooking. I feel it's like smoky. Hold on. I gotta like do like triple action here, guys. See, it looks like a real naan kind of now. I thought it would like swell up more, but it's not. But it looks good though. Yeah, it looks good. I know, I like it naan looking. Like it looks like a real naan. It's swelling up a little bit, but it's good. I can tell it's good. Flip it this one now. Gotta get it to my and this is what it looks like, right? Hold on, there's like a lot of stuff going on here. Hey Mel, congratulations to Amira today on her graduation. This is what it looks like, it's looking like. So I've got more, I've gotta flip some more over here. I've gotta look for my thing. Hold on. I gotta stop moving the camera, hold on. That's pretty good. And I gotta turn my squash, give me a minute. Squash is losing a lot of water. So it's definitely steaming nicely. Gotta turn that up. And then I also gotta, oh, you're very welcome. I also gotta knead another one, right? Like, this is the thing about making roti on live. It can be like back and forth, back and forth. Hey, Davey, how are you? A lot of back and forth. So hopefully I'll get to try the squash with you guys. Oh, good, good. Nothing like visuals. Right, Dolly? Dolly, I gotta tell you, you've been doing like an amazing job with everything, with your cooking. I'm so inspired by looking at you. I know you're saying that to me, but I've been like super inspired looking at you. Hi, monster. I've got a monster here. Oh my God. Now it's gonna be dinner time. No. After. Aww. All right, after dinner time, baby. Avery wants Nutella. Nutella before dinner. Perfect. It's like really, really nice, right? Wah, sorry, I keep moving it. Just trying to get my angles for you guys to see me and for me to be on with you. Like I said, this is the deal with roti. Once you're on with roti, you gotta like keep, it's like a couple step process, right? So it's pretty easy too, and I'll tell you what I put in my sada roti. Just I put a little bit of I put warm water with flour, baking powder. You gotta make sure you put enough baking powder, guys, and a little bit of butter, believe it or not, and just maybe like a sprinkle of yeast, like just tiny bit of yeast. And that's it. That's all I put in it. It just comes out like this. And of course, you know, flour. So, and I let it sit. I let it sit for like an hour. And you just want it to be like really soft, right? See? That's how you know it's like gonna come out good. So there we go. So here we go. I don't know what Alexa's playing, right? Alexa's just playing what it wants to play. I didn't even put that on. Alexa just decided, once I'm on with you guys, I'm just gonna act up. It's like the norm. Ah, needs a flower. Got a flower. The rolling pin. Or the belga. Whichever one you want to call it. Same thing. Gotta turn my other roti. Hold on. I'm actually gonna just do two and just leave one aside. So you guys don't forget, if you're like locally and you want to order some flowers, like my friend, he's literally, I've known him since I was 11, right? So just, you know, check out Flower Explosion, it's really good. I'm actually going to post it up in Priya's kitchen and let you guys get the information, but he's really good. So really, really good. So that's always easy when you have people, you know. And they last a long time. That's the best part too. They last a really long time. I always seem to do, hey Jen, how are you? I always seem to do stuff that I gotta work on my arms. It's like I need to work on my arms. So I find cooking ways to work them out, apparently. So here we go. This one's like kind of big, but it's okay. Okay, so I'm back here. Hold on, I'm gonna bring this over here. Okay. Swelling up nicely. Even in the pan, it's swelling up nicely, right? So, actually, I'm gonna leave this one and not do this one, because Avery wants one with like no brown on it. So I'm just gonna leave one aside for Avery. This will be it. Sorry guys. Just like contemplating, but I gotta make sure my monster gets the stuff she wants. My picky monster. Only cause she's like her mommy, right? Ooh, the squash is like steaming up like crazy. Look at this. Oh, so good. And I didn't add water to it, right? Really good. And it's on low heat. I'm gonna lower the heat even just a little bit more. Just to turn this heat up, lower that one. So there we go. I'm gonna get a tissue to also wipe my pan because I don't like when my pan's brown. I've got one more. What's going on, Jen? I saw Sasha's birthday yesterday, so excited. She's 16, so happy. My cousin's daughter in Canada, so nice. The sweetest. I've got amazing cousins, right? All over the world. That's why Facebook, WhatsApp, everything is so important to us, because my first cousins are literally all over the world. So I'm actually gonna put this one on right now. Let that rise up. I'm going to wipe this. So I'm gonna wipe that up. And I'm going to put my other one on. I'm gonna flip that in a minute. Let me show you guys how it's swelling up. Look at this. You see that? That's some good stuff. That is some good stuff. Woo! See that? That is some good stuff. I'm glad you got to see the action of the rise. So it worked. So literally like your own homemade naan, right? Just cook it on the pan and then put it on your stovetop. It works. It works. I'm gonna have to flip my other one second.
Get more free music on your favorite devices. Just download the Amazon Music app.
So let's go with this one. I've got two more to go. And then hopefully my squash will be done. And I'll get to eat and show you guys. And just a little prepping before, right? Helps, like it goes a long way. So can't go too wrong. You definitely want to do your ends. And I told you guys what I put in my my Sada Roti and then mix it. And I do mix my roti. Yes, I mix my roti inside of the cake mixer. Don't ask, it's easy. I gotta work my hands all day, so. This is going on here now. Woo! And this is going on here now. Should be like another rise here going on in like a minute. And then I'll do a flip again. You just gotta watch it, right? You definitely gotta watch it. You don't want it to, you don't want it to burn. Hey Carlin, how are you? I'm gonna flip this over. Look at this. I just want to impress my Guyana people right now, because my Guyana people's got this down pack, right? But don't worry, us New York girls got it too. We figure it out. We figure it out. That. Going to do another. Hi, Susan. I'm so glad you're on. Hi, love. How are you? I'm cooking, if you would like to know, I'm making Sada Roti, as I'm sure you're seeing, with squash, stew squash with goat. So, should be good. We've got some, it's like probably like 70 degrees right now, and it's a little dreary in New York, so kind of like good, a good roti night. I didn't even think of that. I was just like, oh, let me see what I have when I came home from work today, and I was like, okay. That's what I have, so that's what I'm making. Okay, so here's another one. And I did do 8 roti. So I'm gonna send food to Queens. So do that one. Gotta switch my roti. Oh yeah, it's pretty good. Literally gonna show you what's going on with the roti. Like, I put it on the pan and then I put it on the stovetop, and look, it starts to swell up, right? Look at this. Ah! Now I gotta like get off the camera so I can like flip my roti. There we go. You definitely want to lower back your stove, right? Once you step away from it. It's a little bit of a process, but so worth it. So worth it. So I'm on my last one. Definitely want to keep your rolling pin always floured, right? Tony Braxton's killing it right now in my kitchen. Okay, I'm literally like at my last one. So I'm actually gonna just leave the camera right here. It's nothing like some hot Sada Roti, some stew. Working it today. Let me check on my stew. Looks good. Why is my phone reconnecting? Why? Got everything set up. Why is it doing that still? I have no idea. It's like weird. Okay, so putting this on here. Wiping this up. Flipping this over here. And literally I cook 8 roti with you guys on, right? Just to let you know. Just FYI. If anyone didn't realize, like I literally cooked 8 roti with you guys on. So here we go. This is up, that's up. Just gonna take my other one out in a minute. Woo, going in the bowl. It's So let's go with the next one. And the pan is what's gonna like cook it, right? You wanna make sure the flour is like cooked all the way through, because if you just put it there, I'm afraid it might be a little raw still. So that's why I just, steam's coming from the squash. That's why I make sure like I just cook it in the pan first. Usually the process is to put it in a microwave. I know a lot of people do that. Like why not just put it on the stovetop? Like not even a big deal. You just gotta regulate yourself and regulate the stove, that's all. Sorry, got a phone call. I don't know why anyone's calling me now. It's like a weird number, so. This is swelling up over here. Piping up, piping up. There we go. I'm gonna bring my squash back over and show you guys what's going on with it, right? And taking my last roti up after it's like rising over here. Definitely want to show you guys what's going on in here. Look at that. That looks really good and it smells even better. No joke, it smells like ridiculous. Usually I have my fan on, but it's, oh my god. The goat is so soft from, hey Nisa, how are you, lovey? Hey Cammy. So the goat is so soft just from me steaming it before, right? So it's like, definitely like a double process, but so worth it. And I'm not joking, the smell is like ridiculous. I'm actually going to plate some and have some while I let it just simmer down a little bit more. I didn't even add water to it. I'm gonna wash my hands up because I'm touching everything. Hey Sahira, how are you? Today was my last day for, you know, school, graduation, online, everything. So I will be cooking more often with you guys for a couple of days, because, or whenever I cook, you know how that is. But definitely doing that a little bit more because I'm done until I start summer school, online school. So that'll be July 6th. So definitely had, it was busy, but last week I was just so busy I couldn't even get with it. Oh, miss you too, Anissa. So definitely want to get that going and want to have some fun with you guys with my cooking. So hopefully I'll come up with some stuff like today. I don't know, I just came up with it, but let me just grab a plate. Plate this up and I want to show you guys, because I definitely got eat with my hands, right? With my fingers. I eat with my mouth. Like, I use my fingers to eat my food today. Real Guyanese style today. Oh my god, even the gravy is like, like to die for. And you definitely want gravy in this because you're gonna be eating roti with it. So I just lowered back the heat. The squash just needs to cook, just steam a little bit more, so I'm gonna leave it on there, but I'm actually okay with just eating it right now. So moving this over, moving everything over. I got my flour all over, it's okay. Look at what's going on with this right now. And I literally made that on with you guys, right? Like, very, very naan, very naanish, like fresh naan. Look at this. So, and here's my, I'm actually excited to eat this. Don't ask. Because the goat is so soft, I could just tell. I could tell, it's just so, it's perfect. I didn't even taste it for salt. Like, I feel like I already know it has enough. Hey, Mary Kitchen. I Julissa.
Hi.
Oh my god. This is so good. Like, I just want to show you the meat, right? Like, look. Like, just... Oh yeah. Sure, Mary. I owe you doll, Mary. Mary Kitchen, it was wonderful to see you. Hi, Julissa. It was wonderful to see you at graduation today, I must say. So roti and squash and goat, you never try it? You're missing out. Try it. I'm telling you, I just cook what I like, right? Or sometimes just whatever I have. So good night, Zahira. I keep eating with you guys. This roti is so... So good. I can't even tell you. I'm gonna stop eating. Great to see you too. Anyway. I should stop eating so I could say bye. That would be like the first thing, right? Right now. But I'm gonna let that steam a little. You saw how I made it. I told you how I made the goat. You saw how quick that was. And try it. I would even make that with cabbage, right? Like, that's one of my favorite vegetables. And cabbage is like, it's very watery. It doesn't, like, you know, get stuck in your stomach or anything. Just like, it's very easy. It's a very easy vegetable and light on the tummy. Anyway. Hey, Seam. How are you? Anyway, guys, thanks for hanging with me. Thanks for commenting. Thanks for watching. Thanks for supporting Priya's Kitchen. Please share this page if you like it. Please like Priya's Kitchen. Please check out our One Guyana Food Festival 2020 and support all of the cooks on there. And thanks for everyone put it together and that helps out with it. And to Mr. Snow as well, of course. And the beautiful bouquet behind me. Not Avery, the bouquet. if you want a great, nice bouquet, he's done a lot of stuff for us. It's from Floral Explosion in Richmond Hill. Let me know. I will post it up. Actually, I'll post this information up on Priya's Kitchen. So again, share this page if you like it. It was great hanging with you guys this evening. Sorry, I had a long day. My voice, I definitely spoke a lot today. So always keep good vibes going and have a great evening. I'm gonna go finish my squash and roti because it tastes really, really good with my goat. Have a good night and stay well. And like I said, always keep good vibes going. And I will talk to you guys soon. Mukesh, squash with goat and sada roti. Hi, Farah. So have a good night and I'll talk to you guys soon. Ciao.